Hello students, welcome. In today's class we are going to discuss about second unit. In our previous class we discussed that is second unit, that is about literature for the language development, literature in language classroom, literature in language teaching. So after this literature in language teaching, there are various reasons of using literature in the language teaching we discussed in that class. This class also come under the unit second. In previous class unit second we discuss literature in language teaching, and there are various reasons for using literature in the classroom, in ELT classroom, English language teaching classroom. So being based on the same unit, we have some topics have been missing here. We are going to discuss about this. There is a differences between the use of literature and the study of literature. There is a differences between the use of literature and the study of literature. Especially the role of literature in the English language teaching classroom has been reassessed, and many now view literary text as providing rich linguistic unit, effective stimuli for students to express themselves in other languages and potential source of learner motivation. Definitely literature is always helpful. Literature is providing a handful opportunity to learn about the language. It provides various linguistic input. So literature is really fruitful and effective to be used in the classroom, in English language teaching classroom and in the classroom activities. So literature is a group of works, as you know that literature is a group of works of art made of words, most are written, but some are passed on by word of mouth. So teaching literary text is always interesting one. So here we have two things here. One is about the use of literature, and next one is the study of literature here. So let's go to discuss. The study of literature means literary text be studied here, the study of literature. We have two aspects. One is the use of literature and the study of literature here. Literary text can be studied in their original forms or in simplified or abridged version here. An increasing number of studies in English are written, especially for learners of other languages. Literature includes the work of writers from a diverse range of countries, from different countries. Many authors are there. Only the authors from England, only the authors from British, they have not become only the writers. Beyond the countries, beyond the different, all around the world, different types of writers, they have created different types of literary texts, literary genres there. So, which is very good for teaching and learning process there. Being based on it, that is the matter to be discussed here. Every change that has happened in the world, be it political, historical, social, environmental, philosophical, artistic, or even scientific, has manifested itself in the literature of the times there. So here, the study of literature means we can study literature in various way. There are various classroom activities. The types of literary texts that can be studied inside the and outside the ELD classroom can be different here. Let's go there. So that is short stories and poems, novels, plays, essays, biographies, literary text content, different types of literary genre. So learning literature provides a broader perspective of the world around us. It has made learners less judgmental and more accepting of diverse opinions. Various critical theories, which are tools that help us in analyzing or given literary works at the different levels. So that is the different literary text. Then we have next concept is the use of literature. How can literary text be used? Literary text can be used in different way, because classroom work with the literary works may include pre-reading activities, interactive work, on the text and follow-up activities. Generally, literary text provide opportunity for multi-sensorial classroom experiences and can appeal to learners with different learning styles. On the other hand, literary text also offer a rich source of linguistic input. So from the literary text, we can get ample source of knowledge. We can input ample source of linguistics, that is the language from that literary text. So literary text always helpful to develop the learner's language development. That is, and on the other side, it also helps to develop their understanding of other culture, awareness of differences, and to develop tolerance and understanding. So literary text can be used in various way. Okay. Next one is, what are the approaches to using literature with the language learners? Next topic is that. So here approach implies how we deal with different types of literary text to understand or to teach the students. How can we handle classroom activities? How can we, when we enter the classroom, how can we move the lesson? How can we take the lesson from our own perspective? So generally, there are two approaches to using literature with the language learners. They are textual approach and non-textual approach. Especially textual approach, in this approach, critical appreciation of the literary text is made. Here, literary text is taught all in all. You know, the teachers goes line by line of the text given there. So the text is used in the class. The learners go through the text and analyze the textual information of the text. This approach evaluates two elements, language and style. Language and its variety have greater role in the text. Language includes phonic and graphic substance. Similarly, a style is an idiosyncratic skill of the writer to express the message. There are a number of different styles, and we have to see how successfully they are used, such as descriptive style, narrative style, reflective style, so on there. Then next one is a non-textual approach. Especially in non-textual approach, this approach focuses that a literary text can be taught more clearly and effectively. Here, non-textual approach means while teaching the literary text, giving background information, background knowledge of the text, setting and the writers, focusing on that background information of the writer, of the author, of the poet, and giving the teacher gives greater importance to the extra information about the writer and extra information about the particular text. So that is non-textual approach. So teaching literary text have different types of approach, but we discuss that is textual approach and non-textual approach here. So this is useful for the learners of higher and longest texts like novels, dramas, epics, that can be useful for teaching, that is using this non-textual approach. Then we have next topic, literature for development of language, different language skill. Literature is how literature is helpful to develop different types of language skill. So literature holds a prominent role in students' personal development, since the reader becomes attached with the literary text through detailed patterns of language asset to develop skills and competence. So literature is always beneficial to develop different types of language skill. So literature serves as an often welcome break from the constant repeated drills and old list, while keeping interest high in reading comprehension and language learning. So language skills are necessary. So especially to develop the different types of language skill, either that is listening, speaking, reading and writing, literature is handy. Literature is really helpful there. So there are four types of language skill. Listening skill, the use of different literary text can be beneficial in developing learners' listening skill. Nursery rhymes can be recorded from the native speaker and played in the class in order to develop authentic listening skill. So literature is helpful to develop listening skill. Then we have speaking skill in literature. There are different productive ideas there. That is oral, especially dramatic element is there. Speaker produce language orally with the purpose of conveying his ideas to the speaking skill can also be developed by using different literary text. Different types of literary text can be beneficial to develop speaking skills of the learners there. Then we have reading. The skill of reading could be either reading aloud or reading comprehension. Reading could aim at recognizing the alphabetical learners and relating them to their sounds. This kind of reading is usually practiced by the beginners who want to master the pronunciation of words and sentences rather than understanding what they actually means. So here, literature is always beneficial for developing reading skill as well. Then we have writing skill. Whatever the things they have listened, whatever the thing they have spoken, whatever thing they have read, they provide its output. The output is writing skill. So literature is always fruitful to develop writing skills of the learners. Literature can be a powerful and motivating source for writing in ESL and EFL, both as a model and as a subject matter. Literature as a model occurs when students' writing become closely similar to the original work of the work or clearly imitates its content. So literature is beneficial to develop a writing skill. So overall, literature is helpful for developing different types of language skill, listening, speaking, reading, writing. Student, then we have our next topic, that is literature for the development of different language aspect. So how literature is helpful to develop different language aspect, literature enriches language skills in a number of ways. So it should not be a surprise that literature offers a great opportunity to expand and enrich language skills. So not only developing language skills, but also developing literature is helpful for developing language aspect here. So here language aspect referred to pronunciation. Literature is helpful for developing pronunciation because pronunciation a vital role in the sound system of any language. So pronunciation, for developing pronunciation, literature can be helpful there. Then vocabulary, to extend the learner's vocabulary, because when they go through different types of literature text, they can increase their vocabulary power. They can get to know unfamiliar words and expression such as idioms from the literature text. So in this way, literature is really helpful for developing vocabulary there. Then we have grammar as well. Using literature text for teaching grammar has been considered an effective teaching materials for students to develop basic and sub language skills. So literature is always helpful to develop different types of language skills. So that is grammar as well. Students, I hope you got the concept. In previous class we discussed that is why literature used in the classroom. What are the benefits that we get from using literature in language teaching in ELD classroom? Especially literature is helpful for developing different language skills, let's say listening, speaking, reading, writing. And on the other side, literature is helpful for developing different type of language aspect, that is vocabulary, pronunciation, and grammar. Students, I hope you got the concept. Today I like to sign out the class here. If you have any confusion, don't forget to comment here. Hope to meet you in our next class. Don't forget to like and subscribe my channel, Versatile Learning Network. See you in our next class. Take care. Goodbye.